Hello, welcome friends. Myself, Dr. Pradeep Jain. I have done my PG from Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University. And I am currently a reader in Jeeva Kaurved Medical College, Chandauli, Varanasi. And I have been practicing as a diabetologist in the city of Varanasi for last more than 20 years. Today, the topic of my talk is about controversial plants in Dravyaguna or in the Ayurveda. As we already know that Ayurveda is a Trisutratmak, that means Hetu, Ling and Aushad. This tri-pharmacic Ayurveda has been continuing for the time immemorial, and this virtuous knowledge was known to Brahmaji first, followed by the Indra and then Rishi Bharadwaj. Ayurveda provides the knowledge of etiology, that is Hetu, Ling, that is symptomatology, and therapeutics, that includes Aushad. And it not only includes the therapy or living style or treatment profile for healthy persons, but also for sick persons. Now, as we know that Hetu Ling Aushad, this Trisutratmak Gyan in Ayurveda. Now, Hetu and Ling, these both factors can be modifiable because Hetu and Ling depends on various factors, like kaal, samay, environmental factors, etc. So these are modifiable. But aushad cannot be modified. In our shastras or in sanhitas, the aushad or the treatment part, which has been written or which has been told by our saints, the principle of that cannot be modified. So in this Hetu Ling and aushad, Aushad Gyan is very important because in its deficiency or absence, both Hetu and Ling are useless. Now, why it is important, Aushad Gyan is important? Because when a drug is understood perfectly, it can be used as an ambrosia. But the use of a drug that is not understood perfectly may work as poison, weapon, fire or a bolt of thunder. Yatha visham, yatha shastram, yatha agnir nirjatha, tatha aushadam vigyatam, vigyatam ritam yatha. This verse has been taken from Charak Sutrasthan, first chapter. Again, to highlight this, if one who knows the uses and actions of the herbs, though not acquainted with their forms, it calls a pharmacologist, then what need be said of the physician who knows the herbs from all aspects? Yog vittap rupyas tasam tattva vidvichate kim punaryo vijaniya doshadi sartha vishak. That means a physician should know all types and all uses and actions of a medicine. Now, here is the point. Our texts are full of medicinal plants, but again, the current identification and use is the most important thing that every physician should know and implement. But the problem is that in our sanhitas or in our shastras, some of the plants, they are known by different names, and this is the root of controversy of the medicinal plants. Now, this root of controversy about medicinal plants lies in our past, because India is a very vast country and with various languages, dialects and various types of persons. It has been already said that kos kos par badle pani, char kos par vani. Now, name of various plants are given according to their morphological characters. Like, for example, Darvi Patra, which has been given because of the shape of the leaf, and place of origin like Magadhi. And the names of various plants are also given according to their action, like Vatari or Ranjak, etc. Now, in our sanhitas or shastra, one name is given to many plants. For example, Bhadrayam tu Bala Nili, Danti Kashmiri Sariva, Shvetadri Karni Gauri cha Sapta Prokta Bhishagvara. Here the word Bhadra, it has been used for seven plants. Now, some other examples of such type of knowledge is Rajni has been given to Haridra or Manjishta. Mahoshadam is known for Shunti and Rasun. Ushnam, Shunti for Piplimul, Shunti and Piplimul. Ushna, Chavve and Pipli. So, the problem of controversial drugs requires tackling from several angles or aspects, such as literary, That means what our Shastras or Sanhita says, botanical identification, which is the most important part in today's scenario, pharmacognostical and pharmacological aspects, which includes the subject of clinical pharmacology, clinical studies, which includes a clinician, and collecting data from field studies, that is local populations such as cow herders, goat herders, and traditional healers, etc. So it is obvious that if one doesn't have the knowledge of Sanskrit, Ayurveda, botany, and clinical knowledge, then one cannot solve the mystery of controversial drugs. So that's why every plant given in our Sanhitas has to be currently identified, so that our new generation can easily identify that plant and use it accordingly. Now, in this series of controversial plants, I would like to start with one plant that is known as Gojibya. Now, what does Gojibya means? Go means a cow and jibya means a tongue. The plant which have its leaves like the tongue of a cow, that is hirsute and rough. If you examine the tongue of a guy or a goat, it has a typical features, that is, it is a hirsute and it is rough, which has been known in our Shastras as Kharpatra ya Kharparni. Now, these photographs are of Anosma bracteata, which has been taken as Gojibya nowadays. If you can see on the left side, the green plant is there, and on the right side, the dried part of that plant is there. Now, what is Anosma bracteata? How does it look like? It is a hairy shrub with purple to yellow color flowers, grows in the Himalayas at about 11,500 feet. The radical leaves are larger, from 15 cm to 25 cm wide, and caulin leaves are 5 cm long and 2 cm wide. Upper leaves are ovate, lanceolate, silky, white beneath, and lower leaves are lanceolate. In Charak Sanhita and Shushra Sanhita, Gojibya has been mentioned in the Shak work. In Shushra Sanhita, it has been named as Goji, and its rough leaves are used for the Lekhan Karm, with Shravan, Lepan, Vran Chikitsa. Kashaya tu hita pitte swadu pak rasa hima, lagvi manduk parni te tadvaj Gojivika mata. Now, Acharya Chakrapani has delineated the meaning of Gojibya as Dharvi Patrika. That means it looks like the Dharvi. Acharya Dallan have also named as Dharvi Patrika. And the indication for Dharvi Patrika is, it is used in fever. Gojibya, Gozika, Gobhi, Dharvika, Kharparni, Gojibya, Vatala, Shita, Grahani, Kaf, Pitunut, Hridya, Prameh, Kasasran, Vajwar, Hari, Lagu, Komala, Tubra, Tikta, Swadu, Pakrasa, Smrita. This verse has been taken from the Bhavprakash. Now, this plant is used in Yunani medicine as gaojam for the treatment of cough and respiratory disorders. If you clearly see, or if you minutely see the leaves of Anosma bracteata, it has got many spines and is very hirsute in touch. So it cannot be taken as sharp, because if the leaves are hirsute or rough, so it will be difficult for a person to chew it or swallow it. So it cannot be taken as a shark. So that's why we have left it at this point, and other plants I will discuss, and later on I will draw the conclusion that how Anosma bracteata and where Anosma bracteata should be taken as this Gojibya, and where other plants should be taken as. Now, another plant which is in Gujarat is known as Galjibhi or Gojibhi. This plant has been botanically identified as Elephantopus scabber, which is also from the family Boraginaceae. Now, here if you see this plant, you see that the leaves of this plant are smooth. They are not hirsute. Botanically, this plant is known as Elephantopus scabber, again from the family Boraginaceae. Its leaves are also Darvikar, which you can easily see. And the leaves of this plant are used in the treatment of wounds and skin diseases. Locally, the traditional healers are using this plant in the treatment of wounds and skin diseases. Its panchang along with rice is given in fever. but the leaves of Elephantopus scabor are smooth and not hirsute. Acharya Priyavas Sharma ji considered Gojibya as shark and Goji as Yunani medicine as Gao Java. Probably Acharya Bhavamrish has also considered both the same. Now another plant known as Caxinia glauca savi, Gao Java, is also considered as Gojibya, but this plant is native in northern Iran. This plant was later on cultivated in India also. This plant is a subshrub having height of 50 to 60 centimeter. Its leaves are simple and alternate lanceolate in shape. It is used as diuretic, tonic, immunogogue and in respiratory ailments. This is Caxinia glauca savi. Now here you can see that the leaves of this plant are not as big or are not as wide as that of Anosma or Elephantopus. The flowers of this plant are taken as Gule Gao Java. Now another plant which is locally known as Van Gobi is also taken as Gojibya, which is more nearer to the fact that Gojibya is a shark. This is that plant, and botanically this plant is known as Lunia esplendifolia. This is from the family Asteraceae. This plant is found in North India, West Bengal and Andhra Pradesh. The leaves of this plant are lanceolate, widely serrated and are less wider than Anosma bracteata, as you can easily see. Now this plant in traditional medicine and in Ayurveda medicine has been used as a galactagogue. Now some other plants like Trichodesma indicum, this is again from the family Boraginaceae, which has been now accepted as Adhyapushpi. This plant Trichodesma indica is also known as Gojibya, but later on it was botanically identified as Adhyapushpi. Moreover, this plant is Katu Tiktin Ras, Lagu Ruksh in Gun, Ushn Virya and Katu Vipag, which is different from Gojibya described in our Brethrai. Gojibya is Madhur Tiktin Ras, Lagu Snigdin Gun, Sheet Virya and has Madhur Vipag. Again, the Gun Dharma of these two plants are different, or rather you can say opposite. So this plant can't be taken as a Gojibya. Some other plants like Strobilus asper, Borrego officinalis, which is found in Himalayas, Dehradun and Mussoorie or all that area, and Chusa strigosa are also considered as Gojibya, but because of their cusped sheen appearance, but their Gundharma are different. All these plants like Strobilus asperus, Borrego officinalis and Chusa strigosa, these are all from the family Boraginaceae. And because of their cusped sheen appearance, they have been considered as Gojibya, but their Gundharma are different. So these cannot be taken as Gojibya. Now, if you see all the discussion and all the plants and all the Gundharma of various plants, it has been now concluded that Gojibya mentioned in the shark work should be taken as Elephantopus scabor, because it can be easily chewed, it can be easily swallowed, but the problem is only that it is not kharsparshi. And wherever Gojibya is mentioned as Aushad, it should be taken as Anosma bracteata, where Acharya Shushruta has described for Lekhanka, because it is hirsute and rough in nature. So we can say, or we can conclude, that Gojibya mentioned in shark work should be taken as Elephantopus scabor, and wherever Gojibya is mentioned as Aushad, it should be taken as Anosma bracteata. Thank you.